you want to do business online, you need a website. Whether you're a freelancer or you're an agency or you're a content creator, your website helps you create a professional online presence and it gives you a platform to showcase your products and services to potential customers. Also, it can be a very effective tool to generate leads and sales to your business. That is why in this video, I'm going to show you the easiest and the fastest way to build a professional website for your business using muzu.co. With this tool, you can build your website without needing any technical skill or having any prior experience in web design. It already has all the tools and features you need for your website built in. And all you just have to do is to click some buttons, type in some details about your business, and your website will be ready in just a matter of minutes. Muzu.co also gives you the flexibility to either create your website with your PC or with your mobile phone, depending on the one you prefer. But in this video, I'm going to show you how you can get everything done on your smartphone. To get started, come over to Muzu.co. To make it easier for you, I'm going to leave a link to this website in the description below. If you use that link, you are going to get a 30-day free trial where you get to use this tool without paying for it upfront. So click the first link in the description and that will bring you over to this page. And right on this page, you are going to see all of these details about Muzu.co. So you can see create your website in minutes, don't know how to code, no need to learn, and you can create and publish your website in just 6 steps. Here you can see the different plans that they have. If you have the time, you can just scan through this page and get all of these details for yourself. But basically, what you want to do is to click on get started. And the first step, we will need to create a new Muzu account. So you can see that you have different options. You can sign up with your Google account, your Facebook account, your WhoGoes account, or you can sign up with your email address. I'll just go ahead and sign up with my Google account. So I'll click sign up with Google, select the Google account I want to use, and then I just need to enter my phone number right here and then select my country, which is Nigeria, and then click on continue. Here, you will need to select the type of Muzu account you want to create. If you want to use Muzu.co to design websites for yourself, for your business and all of that, then you can choose design website for self. But if you want to use Muzu.co as a service where you design websites for others, you choose on design website for others. The type of account you choose will affect the type of features you are going to see along the line. So depending on how you intend to use this tool, just select the right option. I'm going to choose design website for self and then click on continue. So get started, get a stunning website created just for you by you and all of that. Start by answering a few questions. What type of website do you want to build? For this example, I'm going to create a business website. So I select business or company. If you are creating a portfolio or profile website, you can just select portfolio. Then I'll go ahead and click on continue. These details you are going to provide here will help Muzu customize your website to your need. So here I just need to enter my business name and just give a short description of my business. And to make everything fast and easy for me, I already have all the details I'm going to need for this website. So I'm going to copy my business name and then come over and paste it right here. Then tell us about your business. I'll just copy this short description that I have for this business and then come back here and paste again. Then I'll just click on continue. All right, add your business services. This way I get to enter all the services I offer in my business. So I'll just enter design. This is just a demo website that I'm creating. So all of these details, I just made them up. I'll just click on add. Then I'm going to add branding, click on add. I'll also add content creation and then let's say social media management. All right, these 4 different categories are just enough for me: design, branding, content creation, and social media management. So let's assume these are the services I offer in this business I'm creating. So I'll just click on continue. Then add contact information. This if you want customers to contact you. If you don't add your contact information to your website, you can just click on skip, but it's always a good idea to have a point where customers can get to reach out to you from. So I'm going to enter the email address for my business. Let's say the email address is support@graphics.com. Then let's say this is a phone number. Then you can enter the address. I'll just type in Lagos, Nigeria, and then click on continue. All right, so you can also add team members. Of course, that's if you have other people working on the business with you. You can add their name, their position, upload their image. And if you don't have team members to add or you don't want to add team members, you can just click on skip. And whatever you're entering here, you can always edit them later on. It's very easy. So I'm going to enter some details here. Now I'm done adding all of that. I have 3 team members here. I can just click on continue. Then the next step is to get a domain name for your website. Your domain name is how people are going to locate your website on the internet. You can decide to skip this step if you don't want to get a custom domain name for your website right now. In which which case you have to use a generic domain name. For instance, emmanueladanu.com is a custom domain name, but if you skip getting a custom domain name, then you have to use something like emmanueladanu.muzu.co. All right, so that's just the difference. If you have the money, it would be a good idea to get a custom domain name for your business. But if you cannot do that right now, you can always buy a custom domain name when you are ready and add it to your site. So I'm going to search for a domain name here. Let's say glt.com. I'll click on search. glt.com is not available, but gltblog.com is available, and it's going to cost me 9,900 naira per year. So I'm going to choose gltblog.com. Then here I'll need to enter my contact details to complete my registration for this domain name. So I'll just enter all of these details that they need. After entering all of these details, I'll click on continue. At this point, I'll need to select a plan for my website. They have a free plan, and you can see the features here: access to site editor, create mobile responsive site, and your website has a limit of 500 visits per month. Then they have the premium plan, which costs 3,500 naira per month. And then for this, you get 3 gigabytes of storage for your site, up to 1,000 site visits per month, free SSL, no watermark on your site. You can add a custom domain name, create mobile responsive site, and then access to site editor. And then they have this pro plan, which is 5,000 naira per month. You get to manage multiple sites, 5 gigabytes of storage for your site, 2,000 visits per month, free SSL, and all of these features. I'll go for the premium plan, which is 3,500 naira per month. Whichever plan you choose, you can activate a 30 days free trial. So you will not be charged for the website plan until the 30 days free trial period expires and you still want to continue with your website. So I'll click on activate trial. From this point, it gets even more interesting. You get to select a template for your site. So you just need to go through all of these different templates that they have and then look for the one that you like the most. For me, I'm going to pick this very simple template called Montana. This is a summary of my bill, and I'm going to pay 9,900 naira in total for the domain name that I'm buying. So I'll just click on save and continue. You have 2 payment options, either PayStack or PayPal. I'm going to select PayStack so that I can pay with my Naira card. I'll just go ahead and complete the payment. After successfully making the payment, I can go ahead to my site editor, and basically this is what it looks like right now. And the good thing is everything you see here is actually customizable. The images, the background, the text, the buttons. Now, let's say I want to customize this first session. I just need to tap on it, and this editor is going to pop up, which will allow you customize that session whichever way you like. So for the headline, I can just change this to maybe the name of the business. Let me just type in graphics. You can also change the headline color, but I'm going to leave it on black. Then the subtext, I'm going to make this the description of the business. Also, you can customize the color of the subtext as well. If I just click on this, you can select any color you want. And if you have the code for the color you want to use, you can just paste that right here and you'll be good to go. Also, you can use this to customize your buttons. For instance, if I just click on this pencil icon here, you'll be able to edit the text on your button. Let's say I want to change my call to action to maybe book now. And then you can set the action the button is going to trigger. So when people click on the button, do you want to redirect them to a custom link or you want to redirect them to another session on your site? If you want to redirect them to a custom link, check custom link and then paste the URL of the destination you are directing them to. Or if you want this button to direct people to another section on your site, you can just check link to site section and then select the section you want to direct people to. So I'll click on contact, for instance, and click on save. With that, whenever people click on this book now button, they will be automatically redirected to the contact section of my website. Then the media, which is the image you have in this section, you can just tap on it and then you can upload your own custom image, or you can use their stock photo gallery. You can just search for whatever it is you are looking for. So let's say I'm going to search for agency. Let's see what we're going to get. I'm going to use this, for instance. And just in case you can't find an image you like for a website from their gallery, you can always upload your own custom images. So I'll just click on done. If you want to use a solid color as your background instead of an image, just check this box here and you'll be able to select the color you want to use for your background. Now, let's say I'm done doing all of the stuff I want to do here. I'll just click on save changes. Let's go back to here's what it looks like. And then you can follow through this same process and edit all the different sections of your website. So if I want to edit this services section, for instance, I just need to tap on it again. And then this editor pops up and then I just do all the customization I need to do. After you are done editing your website to your satisfaction, the next step is to actually publish your website. And to do that, you just need to click on publish and your site will be live on the internet. Also, you can come over to settings just in case you need to make some touches here. Let's say I'm select an industry for your business. So I'll come over to this industry section and then select, let's say, product and services for me. Then you can enter your Facebook handle, Twitter handle, Instagram handle, and all of these social media links are going to show up on the footer of your website. Then for SEO, to help your site's chances of showing up on search engines, you can set a title, your site author, the keywords, the site description, and all of that. When you are done, click on save changes. Then if you come over to this appearance section, you can get set a favicon for your site, select your site font, the colors of your background, text, buttons, and all of that. Then if you come over to content, you'll be able to work on the different sections of your site. So my site has a header, an about section, services section, facts and figures, team members, contact, and all of that. So you can add a section if you want, or you can remove a section. So if I don't have these facts and figures, for instance, I just need to select these three dots and then click on delete section. Or if you don't delete, you can just click on hide, then it does not show up for people to see. Basically, you just need to play around with this tool, spend some time on it, and you'll be able to catch up and understand all the features that they have for you right here. Finally, let me just show you what this site I've just hurriedly made up will look like on desktop. So if you come over on desktop here, you can see what we have. That means if I put in a lot more time into customization, I can actually make it better than this. And that will be all for this video, guys. I hope you found the information in this video helpful. And if you appreciate the value in this video, please give this video a like by clicking the thumbs up button. And if you have any questions for me, let me know down in the comment section. I'll be there answering your questions. Don't forget to smash the subscribe button and turn on all notifications if you want to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.